الحمد لله رب العالمين وأفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. We continue, inshallah, on these inspirational talks that help you, inshallah, to continue on this path of memorizing the Quran. Inshallah, in a couple of days, we're receiving the holy month of Ramadan, right? And it's mentioned in the traditions that the Prophet ﷺ would pray, "Oh Allah, bless Sha'ban for us and enable us to live until Ramadan." Means to live Ramadan and make use of Ramadan. Imagine the Prophet ﷺ is asking Allah to extend his life so that he will live the month of Ramadan. What does that mean? Means there's a lot of good, a lot of khair in this month. And one of the Sahaba, he saw a dream. He saw a dream. He saw two men in his dream, and both entered Jannah. But one of them entered before the other. And the first one who entered is the brother of the second one. The second one was a shaheed, a martyr. He died defending the Muslim land. So he died as a martyr, and you know the level of martyrs. In the Quran it's mentioned many times that they are alive with their Lord, means they are alive in the gardens of paradise, and they are receiving great rewards from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the martyrs, they have very, very high level in Islam. Yet this Sahabi, this companion of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he saw that the martyr was the second one to enter Jannah. So he entered after his brother who died a normal death. So this companion was surprised. So he came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and he said, "Ya Rasulullah, this is the dream I saw." He said sallallahu alaihi wasallam, "Did not the first one who entered Jannah first, did not he live the month of Ramadan after his brother? And did not he pray 6,000 something rak'at?" Exactly, he said 6,000 something rak'at. If you calculate the salah, you will find 6,000 rak'at. In that year. So he lived 1 year after him, and he earned the month of Ramadan, and he fasted, and he had a lot of salawat, so that gave him a higher level. Or he entered Jannah before his brother. So that shows you the greatness and the importance of this holy month of Ramadan, the blessings of this great one. In regard with the Quran, we have a very nice hadith I'm going to share with you and finish with, inshallah, about that combines fasting with the Quran together, where our beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, الصيام والقرآن يشفعان للعبد يوم القيامة. Fasting and the Quran. There is no off in Ramadan. We don't quit Quran in Ramadan. Because if you read Surah Al-Baqarah chapter 2, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. The month of Ramadan is the one in which the Quran was revealed. The Quran was revealed in the month of Ramadan. Was brought from Al-Lawh Al-Mahfuz to the lower heaven in Laylatul Qadr, which is in Ramadan. Then it started being revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam from the lower heaven to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam during 23 years. So this is the month of Quran. This is the month in which the Quran was revealed. How come we quit the Quran in Ramadan? That doesn't make sense. Of course, we're going to reduce the days just to make it easier for your families. But we're not going to stop. We're going to continue. Because this is the month of Quran, right? This is the month of Quran. Where, in Taraweeh, the Muslims, they read the whole Quran in Ramadan. Every day they read one juz or one surah until they finish the whole Quran. So it doesn't make sense that in the month of Quran, we don't do Quran. That's not good at all. No, Quran is our friend. Do you remember we said صاحب القرآن, the word I told you one day? صاحب القرآن. We have to be the companions of the Qur'an, the friends of the Qur'an. So you don't get bored of your friend. You always like to be with your friend. In Ramadan, in Sha'ban, every year, every time. Until we die, we keep reviewing the Qur'an, learning the Qur'an, strengthening our memorization of the Qur'an, understanding the Qur'an, okay? So, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, fasting and the Qur'an will intercede for the servant of Allah on the Day of Judgment. They will intercede for you. You know what intercede means? You know what intercede means? Who doesn't know? Raise your hand. Don't be ashamed. Don't be embarrassed. Yeah, don't be shy. Good job. If you don't ask questions, you don't learn. And if you feel shy to ask, you will never learn. The Qur'an will intercede for you. I'll give you an example what intercession means. Okay? I'll give you an example. I am, let's say, a principal in a school. Okay? I am a principal in a school. And you misbehaved in the school. You know that your uncle knows me. And he loves me very much. I love him very much. I respect your uncle very much. I love him. There's a very good relationship between me and him. And I made a decision that you will be suspended, let's say, 1 week from school. Now, you go to your uncle, you tell him, Uncle, please, I know the Sheikh, he loves you very much, and you have very good relation with him. Please, can you intercede for me with him? What does that mean? What does that mean? Can you please go and talk to him so that he will forgive me? What is that called?
Intercede.
That's the verb. The noun is intercession. What's the noun?
Intercession.
Intercession. What's the verb? Intercede. The Quran and fasting will intercede for you on the Day of Judgment with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fasting will speak. Allah will make fasting like in a form of a person who will speak. Fasting will say, oh Allah, this person, he quit food and desires for your sake. So, let me intercede for him. Accept my intercession for him. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts the intercession of fasting. And Quran will come. Quran will come. Guys, students of the Quran should never feel bored of reviewing and learning. Should never feel tired of it. You should love it. The Quran will come to you in your grave. I mentioned to you the hadith, the amazing hadith. The Quran will come to you in your grave. After your grave, on the Day of Judgment. Every time the Quran will be with you, if you are with him, if you are learning and you are a true friend and companion of the Quran. May Allah make all of us true friends and companions of the Quran. The Quran will say, oh Allah, he used to stay up late at night reciting me. In another hadith, he will say, oh Allah, he would become thirsty because of reciting me. Sometimes you keep reciting, you feel thirsty. And sometimes you stay up late at night. So Allah will accept the intercession of the Quran. So that's, guys, the reminder of Ramadan and the reminder of the Quran. Ramadan is the month of the Quran. Let us not only continue reviewing and memorizing, not only continue reviewing and coming to the Quran school, but also let us start and plan every day of Ramadan to learn some of the meanings of the verses that we're memorizing. Those surah that you're learning, Surah Al-Nasr, Surah Al-Masr, Surah Al-Ikhlas, Surah Al-Fatiha, Al-Kursi, Al-Falaq, Al-Nas. Let's try learn the meanings in the month of Ramadan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us of the true people of the Quran. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Muhammad, alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin.